Hippolyta, our wedding hour approaches. Four happy days bring in a new moon, but methinks how slow this old moon wanes.
4 days shall quickly sleep themselves into night, and 4 nights shall quickly dream away the time. And then the moon, like a silver bow, new bent in heaven, shall behold the night of our wedding celebration.
Hippolyta, I woo thee with my sword, and won thy love doing thee injury, but I will wed thee in another key, with pomp, with triumph, and with partying. Happy be Theseus, our renowned duke. Thanks, Aegis. What's the news with thee?
Full of anger, cry with complaint. It's my child, my daughter, Hermia. Stand forth, Demetrius. My noble lord, this man hath my consent to marry her. Stand forth, Lysander. Stand forth, Lysander.
Rather, you must look with his judgment.
I do entreat your grace to pardon me, for I know not by what power I may hold, here in such a presence to sleep my thoughts. But I do beseech your grace, that I may know what may befall me in this case if I refuse to wed Demetrius.
Either to die the death, or never again see the society of men. Therefore, Hermia, question your desires, examine well your feelings, for if you refuse your father's will, you may endure the life of a nun, a barren nun, all of your life.
Relent, sweet Hermia. Lysander, quit acting like she's yours.
You have her father's love, Demetrius. Why don't you marry him, and then I can have Hermia?
True, he hath my love, but what is mine to give. And I do give my daughter to Demetrius.
But I am, my lord, as rich and noble as he. My prospects as good as his, if not better, and my love is more than his. And which is more than all these boasts can be, I would love it, beauteous Hermia. Why then should I not marry her? Demetrius, I'm not saying it to your face, courted Nestor's daughter and won her soul. And she, that sweet lady, adores that spotted and unfaithful man.
I must confess, I have heard so much, but come, Aegis, and come, Demetrius. I have some private school and group both with you. As for you, fair Hermia, take time to pause, and by the next moon, look to arm yourself to fit the fancies of your father's desire. Otherwise, the law of Athens yields you up to die the death, or to vow a single life. Let us go.
With duty and desire, we follow you.
How now, my love? Why are your cheeks so pale? How changed the roses that do fade so fast?
Probably for want of rain, which I could easily give thee from the tempest of mine eyes.
In books they say that true lover never reigns so smooth. But we're of a different blood, or a different age, or their parents unsupported.
Called to choose love from another's eyes.
Or, well, if it was a good match, they'd be seized by death and war and sickness, making love as momentary as a sound, swift as a shadow, brief as lightning and the briefest of nights. A good persuasion, therefore, hear me, Hermia. I have a widow aunt, rich and without child. She lives nearby. There I'll marry thee. There where the laws cannot touch us. If thou lovest me, steal forth thy father's house tomorrow night and go to the wood. There I'll wait for thee.
Godspeed, fair Helena. Where are you going?
Fair? Can you call me fair? That fair again unsaid. Demetrius loves you, fair. Oh, happy fair. Your eyes are stars, and your tongue's sweet music is like a lark song to a shepherd's ear. Sickness is catching. If only beauty were contagious too, I'd give up the world, everything except Demetrius to be you. Oh, teach me how you look, and with what art you sway the motion of Demetrius' heart.
I frown upon him, yet he loves me still.
Oh, that your frowns could teach my smiles such skill.
I give him curses, yet he gives me love.
Oh, that my prayers could inspire his affection.
I hate him, and he follows me.
The more I love, the more he hates me.
Folly, Helena, is no fault of mine.
None but your beauty would that fault be mine.
Take comfort, Helena. He shall no more see my face, for Lysander and myself will fly this place. To you our secret plan we will unfold. Tomorrow night, when the moon does shine, through the gates of town we will away. And in the woods, where you and I will want to lie, Lysander and myself will meet. And from thence, we will turn away our eyes, to seek new friends among the company of strangers. Farewell, sweet faithful, and good luck, granted by Demetrius.
How happy some over others can be. Throughout the land, I'm not as fair as she. But what of that? Demetrius thinks not so. What a mistake he makes doting on Hermia so. But I, admiring of his qualities, make the same mistake. Love looks not with the eyes, but with the mind, and therefore is winged Cupid painted blind. Nor hath love's mind any judgment. Before Demetrius looked upon Hermia, he held out oaths that he was only mine. But when he looked upon Hermia, he dissolved, and showers of oaths did melt and fall away. I will go tell him of fair Hermia's fled. Then I have his thanks, and she has not her happiness.